Cheers and welcome my friends, I'm Horath, Drak, and we are playing Europa Universalis IV together with the new DLC, Rights of Man. We're playing on very hard difficulty and with Lucky Nation set to historical. Welcome back, we're Bavaria, and we finally managed to revoke the privilegia, so we have now a huge vassal swarm, ready to sick them on anyone that we want. And I'm gonna call in these counter-espionage guys again, because we do actually have a chance to get something going with England here. They do like us now, so I'm going to Royal Marry them and try if we can't swing an alliance. That would be pretty nice. We'll be able to do that on the 16th of August. I do want to call these two provinces that we took in Italy. And what I also want to do is go after Tuscany, because currently Aragon wouldn't help them because they have high war exhaustion. I have to strike now. I don't have the time to actually go and fabricate a claim and all that. I'm just gonna wait until I can make the alliance with England happen. That would be good. 7th, 8th, 10th. Let's just see. Okay, so go for the alliance. Nice, we've got a new ally. That's good. They don't like us very much, and they also don't trust us very much, but at least this will reduce the aggressive expansion impact that they take from our actions. Now, these guys need to get attacked. I want Italy back into the Empire, and that's the way to go. None of these is actually gonna join this. These guys don't owe me the favors, these guys are in debt, and for these guys it's a distant war, so... Yeah, I mainly have my alliances as defensive pacts now. Let's go for it. Yeah, I can live with the one stability loss. That's fine. And we're gonna have all these guys run into battle. That's gonna be good. Now, how are my subjects looking? The Netherlands are unhappy, which I guess I could change by going for a Diplo Rep guy. That brings them on our good side again, and I guess I'll try to get a royal marriage off. Could also royal marriage these guys, they are pretty important, and I'm gonna royal marry these guys, Teutonic Order, and then we're gonna royal marry the Netherlands. And I think I should also go ahead and improve relations with a bunch of these people. These guys I think are rather disloyal. 23 Liberty Desire. I could actually, I tell you what, I place a relative on the throne of Austria. That's going to be fun. And then we'll try to improve the relations with them. I'm at 6 of 6 diplomatic relations. That's fine. And I could royal marry them as well. Just to get up that trust a little bit more. And yeah, I'm basically just letting my vassals take care of this. I don't need to do anything myself. These calls will continue and then I'll take the land. Which is going to be good. The Italy really should belong to the Empire. That's just how I want it. Oh yeah, and we're paying a lot of money now because our maintenance got raised automatically. That's not what I want. I'm going to bring down the forts. The only fort that I'm going to keep is Mantua. Because that's kind of important. Don't want to lose that one. Because we're still coring in the area. We're sieging down Florence over here. Or Firenze. Everything is looking fine. We're very powerful now. I really like it. Cardinal across the border. Pissing off Hungary. Yeah, why not? Okay, we've got 6 active cardinals now. The Pope hates us, but oh well. That's still fine. So we're improving with Austria. Let's see if a royal marriage actually adds another diplo relation. No, it doesn't. Okay. That's fine. So there's actually no real downside to marrying everyone that can be married. Like these guys, for example. Johann Friedrich von Brunshorn. I guess I could just place relatives on all these thrones. Teutonic Order already has a relative on the throne, but I mean Baden can't. Who has at least a little bit of liberty desire? Netherlands, their government form doesn't allow that, so that's a bit of a pity. Hessen, we're gonna place a relative on the throne. Brandenburg, we're gonna place a relative on the throne. Bye bye, Hohenzollerns. Austria we already did, and that's about it. So yeah, and Styria. Okay, yeah, we're gonna place a relative of ours on the throne of Styria. That's gonna piss them off quite a bit, so we're gonna placate the local rulers, I guess. And then we're gonna royal marry Styria. Hello. Wittelsbachs everywhere. I like it. And then we have to royal marry Hessen. We have to royal marry these guys. Okay, we get reduced ship costs. That's fine. Hessen has already been married. These guys have been married. Styria has been married. These guys are married to us now. And we're improving our relations with them. I guess I could just go for the relations improvement with some of the disloyal guys. We are married. We are married. So that's fine. I wouldn't actually mind taking over the Livonian Order. I wonder if I would be able to vassalize them as is. They do have more than 100 development, but how much development do they have? Country, no, it's alphabetical, that's fine. There, Livonian Order, 243 development. How much does Tuscany have? Well, they Timbuktu, Tuscany over here has 184. Would I be able to vassalize Tuscany? Yeah, 73. So I might be able to vassalize the Livonian Order. Although then I would go over my diplo limit again. That's not really what I want. Just waiting until Florence falls. They're just not using enough cannons there. So that's a problem. Oh, and I could upgrade my military tech, I guess. Light infantry companies. I could also wait a little bit more. Maybe improve the development in my capital province. Because that would also allow me to spend more admin power to do that. I do want Munich to be a bigger thing than Paris. Just because. So let's go. It's gonna be rather expensive. I guess I should have built a university. Local development costs minus 20%. It's expensive, but I guess it's fine. Let's go for that. France has claimed the title Defender of the Catholic Faith. We laugh at their pretension, but that must also mean that they are out of this war. Yeah, they are. Okay. Fine. Be like that. I wonder, what did Muscovy get out of this war? Where is it? Here, Muscovy has accepted peace with Genoa on the following terms. Genoa will be forced to give Muscovy 10% of their income each month to pay for war reparations. Genoa will convert to Orthodox. Okay, that's interesting. Why not? Why not? Okay, yeah, we have mothballed all our forts, I know that. That's fine. These guys can't join a coalition until 38, so that's gonna be fine. These guys still have a guarantee against the Ottomans. I am sort of a mind to actually go after the Ottomans. That would be the ultimate thing. Try to return some land to Hungary. They really have no business holding these provinces over here. But I think Hungary already has a pretty high liberty desire. Yes, they do. They're fighting Tuscany. Yeah, okay, I guess so. They have a high liberty desire over Styria. Should we keep our influence over Styria? It's rather expensive, actually. No. But we're gonna improve relations with them. That's gonna be fine. I could also always bestow the Imperial Grace, which is nice. I could still go for the military tech. Yeah, I really haven't been doing much with the buildings. Maybe that might actually be a thing. Development, buildings. Now, in terms of taxation, There are a couple of things where I could build them. Oh. Only my home provinces haven't really been building buildings. That's a bit shit. I could build cathedrals, though. That's kind of nice. Many factories are also not that expensive. Army buildings. Regimental camp is very expensive. But these guys aren't. Local manpower modifier would be quite good. Well, I guess I conquered a lot of land that already had buildings there. Conscription center. Production. Or counting house. And then we got that. State maintenance, monthly autonomy change. I haven't been building that one anywhere. And then the marketplace, of course. There are some places where building a marketplace would be a very good idea. Like over here in Linz, for example, but that's not part of our thing. So I guess that's not what we're going to do there. I could build... No, right, I can build in my vessels. That's the thing. I'm not sure it's going to help me, though. Let's just go for the taxation for now. So let's actually try to up our taxation a little bit. I'm not going to build in my vessels right now. That is not our thing, right? No, that is a Swiss... This is a Swiss province. And then I could also build these. But these are actually fairly expensive now. And I'm not sure I really need to fiddle with them. Could build one in Bourgogne. One in Charolais. These are mainly useful in high-value provinces. Definitely Prague. And Pilsen. They are nice. Regensburg does it. Mähren is nice. What else do we have over here? 0.7, 0.8, 0.11, 0.13, 0.15 over here. That's good. And yeah, I don't have a lot of these high value provinces, I guess. Let's go and build one in Mainz. And that's going to be it. Munich at least does have a temple, but we're currently building a cathedral in there. No, university. Let's go ahead. Oh, and I have to keep this. Ooh, nice. Former queen consort now rules Poland. That's good. Although it doesn't prevent them from waging wars, which is not good. Can't believe we're taking so long. France has corrupted our officials. Screw you, France. Screw you. I guess I should do some counter-espionage again. I'm going to take some more claims. I'm going to take a claim on Nemours. That's going to reduce our spy network. Could take more claims. Oh, I guess I should have taken one on Champagne. Do we have one? No, we don't. Okay. Well, I only need one claim to actually go to war with them, which I'm looking to do. But first, I want to retake Italy. And ideally, I would also wait until these cores are actually done. Because if I attack these guys... Oh, an Empress Consort of the People. She wants a good amount of money and admin power to reduce the unrest. Yeah, why not, actually? It's going to bring us into another loan, but oh well. We can live with that. I do think that you should actually get the treasury of a vessel that you integrate. Sachsen, because of Frankfurtian intervention. Frankfurt is my vessel, though. That's annoying. Ottomans have slandered the good name of our merchants. We're already doing counter-espionage again against them. They must really have a lot of spy stuff. Clergy has long been one of the foremost pillars of the Bavarian realm, providing not only spiritual guidance but also administrators. Times grow dire, however, and the state has to cover an increasing number of expenses. Okay, we could take some money from them. They would lose loyalty. No, we'll find the money elsewhere. It's fine. Let the clergy rest in peace. Okay.
So now Tuscany has attacked us, I guess because we have a war breach. We're getting towards the point where we actually can finish this stupid war. I'm looking forward to it. I'm not going to take any land until we're done with the coring over here. That would be quite stupid. Already 88%, 100%. So they are completely out. Ancona Aragon must not be very happy that I do this, but cessation of church functions. I really don't want that. I would lose 20 papal influence, but I would gain a stability. That's nice. We're going to decline that one. Ottomans have been discovered building a spy network. Yeah, who's surprised by that? Not I. And our spy network over here is bigger, so let's take another claim. Let's take it on Champagne this time. I would like to cut the heart out of France. That would be kind of nice. Okay, Welschbrixen and Mantua is now part of our realm. Let's just wait for the other two to pop as well. Muden and Ferrara. I'm not sure if I want to make them into states, because I'm looking to conquer quite a bit, and my admin power income isn't amazing. Mainly because my ruler is sort of average. On the other hand, yeah, make it into a state. Why not? And then we could also make these guys into a state. We do have a bunch of states now that we could actually go after. If you have a look, we could have 57 states and we only have 22. So we could be huge if we wanted to. Oh yeah, and all of this is cored. So let's just take the piece. What do we do? Who do we pull off? Let's take the relations improving with Austria away. Rebel uprising, papal separatists. Yeah, okay, that has to happen, I guess, at some point. Are we still building in Munich? No, we're done here. So we got reduced development cost now. Development efficiency, university development. Right, we could go for a cathedral now. Let's try what that does. No, not development, buildings. Cathedral. Oh yeah, that's going to give us 0.25. It's generally worth it to do that in your capital provinces. I'm going to do it everywhere above 0.10. Like this. I mean, it's going to look better now that we have higher stability. 0.10, 0.10, 0.18, and 0.13. Yeah, that looks good. I think that's about the amount of them that we want to build. Oh yeah, over here in Nuremberg, 0.16. Right, that's fine. And then I have to make peace with Tuscany, I guess. So, sue for peace. We're just going to take all the land. Right, that's going to overextend me by 110%. That's not great, but I guess I have to live with it. 60 aggressive expansion. A bunch of countries will join a coalition against me, but do I really care? I think not. I really don't think so. And then we take a bunch of money. Well, can't take all your money. Well, we take some. And we don't have to share it with anyone, because all the people that fought in this war are my people. So, yeah, let's go for it. Why not? Second Bavarian War of Aggression. So we took part of the Empire back. Core all provinces in Tuscany. It's 389. And all of them will be coring right this minute. We have disloyal subjects because overextension reduces your diplo rep. So that's not good. But we'll live with it. Let's just hope that we can weather the storm, core these things, before there's too much of a problem. France has paid off all foreign debt of Genoa, and there's the coalition. Well, you're happy to attack me if you want to. That's fine. And France has entered into the coalition. That complicates things, but oh well. That's fine. Ottoman still hasn't joined. Allied with Brittany and Tunis. Conquer Kaffa. Oh, imports compete with Bavarian quality goods. Our neighbors have established a large colonial presence in the New World. The exports from this distant land have been steadily increasing, and some of the exotic goods have become very popular, even among those who should know better than to be dazzled by curiosities. Recently, our neighbors have gone further, openly fueling this interest, encouraging people to buy American. They are pushing for more imports from the colonies, outcompeting our own goods and depriving good Bavarian people of work. We might get something out of this influx of foreign trade, but the safest option would be to erect barriers to reduce it. Or we might even build a wall and let these guys pay for it. Lose mercantilism? No. No, we want mercantilism. Let's get rid of the Netherlands and Dutch Columbia's opinion. That's fine. We could embrace the Enlightenment now. Dutch liberty desire has gone up again. Really do have to improve our relations with them. I could make them a march. Let's go for royal marriage now. That's something. Should I embrace that thing? The Enlightenment? Let's go for it. I will lose 71 military power. Okay, we're gonna invest that over here. That should do it. Let's embrace it. Reducing our tech cost. That also means that I have to actually go there. Increase our soldiers, or improve them. Now what do we go for? Frederickian infantry of Frederick the Great. That is sort of fitting for Germany. Redcoats, British Army, Bluecoats, French Army, Whitecoats, Habsburg military frontier. Yeah, let's go for the Frederickian infantry. Why not? That's fine. Some provinces are lacking cores, really? Okay. Yeah, I guess I made them into a state and didn't actually core them. We're low on admin power now. And we do have a revolt in Mantua. Not happy about that one. France paid all foreign debt of Genoa. Well, you can do that all day, France, if you want to. The overextension is going to hurt us, though. It's going to be a bumpy ride until we actually got all of that cored. Well, that's just what needs to happen. And actually haven't renamed this army. This is going to be the Italian Corps. We're going to give you that guy. And we're going to march you down. Well, we're going to wait a little bit. Just stay in Verona. We're not going to let these guys conquer that place. Papal Separatists, First Liberation Army. Bad reputation! Our recent strategy to carve new provinces out of whoever happens to be in the way surprisingly seems to have had a somewhat negative effect on our standing among our fellow nations. They're overreacting, as always. Yeah, that is one of the effects of that high level of legitimacy questioned. Tell my heir to start worrying. The bloodthirst shown by Joseph Ferdinand the First has ruined the reputation of Bavaria in the eyes of the world. And now our own subjects are starting to question the legitimacy of such a ruthless ruler. Lose 15 legitimacy, that's pretty bad. But oh well. France has started influencing the knights. Whatever. Whatever, France. Yeah, it's gonna be a bit of a bumpy ride. We've taken a loan. We had a trade league disbanded. I'm gonna keep my military upkeep up, I was just saying. Influence over Aachen has expired. No, we don't need that. And we had people rise up in Siena as well. We won that. Battle of Modena. Tuscan separatists are controlling the region right now, that's not good. But the others are still being caught. It's gonna be a little bit of a bumpy ride. Until we get there, I'm going to bring the speed up even further. Holy cow, they're attacking me! That's amazing, I've never seen that. Or seldomly. I mean, they're losing. Especially because they're attacking while I'm defending a fort. Which is pretty nice. Forts actually do have some sense now. Stay in Mantua, and we're going to keep these guys in Florence. You need a leader. We're gonna give you the Emperor, since this is the Imperial Guard. So that's fine then. And this has been retaken. Let's just wait until this is in our land. And then I think I'm gonna attack the Papal State. Although we do have a truce until 1738. That's a bit of a shame. Who are your allies? Poland and France. I don't have a truce with either of these. I might just attack France, but it'll bring in a coalition. Though on this at this point in time, do I really care about the coalition? I do care a little bit about Sweden. They can be rather annoying. I'm not going to influence Frankfurt again. Let's try and improve relations with Sweden. Maybe we can get them out of the coalition. And these guys are in a coalition. They really shouldn't be in there at all. We're friendly towards them. Give to the state. Good governance would sometimes prompt the nobility and the businessmen of the realm to donate cash to the treasury out of pure patriotism or exchange for the sales of offices. Should I take prestige? No, I'm going to take the money. And we'll actually build something in our capital. Kolyma has failed in their duties and they have doomsday. And our royal marriage with the with Muscovy has ended. Okay, let's bring you back from Styria. And let's go for the royal marriage here. That's going to be fine. Good. Aragon. There's really no need to keep that to keep those favors stored. So let's improve that trust. We have a lot of favors with Denmark as well. Although they aren't too happy with me anymore. I haven't been improving our relations for a long time. I'm allied to their rival. So they might not be too happy about that. Let's try to keep that alliance going for now. And then I think I do have to end the episode. I would have liked to sort of finish coring these, but 75 merchants assassinated. Some countries are apparently so appalled by our foreign policy that they've decided to retaliate by assassinating our merchants in an attempt to strike at our finances. What makes it even more shocking is that it happens even in our own trade notes in Ragusa. Well, it's not exactly our own trade note, but oh well. Can't repay that loan. Yeah, high overextension, going over 100% is nasty. That's for certain. Yeah, I think I'm gonna end it here. Oh, what do we have? New unit types? Oh yeah, we haven't changed our cavalry, so let's do that now. Let's take. Let's take the Uhlans, because Germany actually was using a lot of these Uhlans, so it makes sense. But yeah, I'm gonna end it here. Thank you very much for watching. If you enjoyed this episode of Imperial Aggression, then please leave a like. If you didn't, tell me why in the comments so I can improve. And if you want to see more of this series in the future, please consider subscribing to the channel. I'm gonna continue to conquer Italy, and then we go after France. And I think we also have bill to settle with the Ottomans. How are you looking? Oh, they're actually at war. Yemen, Al-Juran, and Hormuz. I wonder why Muscovy is bringing all these troops over here. That's an interesting question. They can't form Russia because they don't have Neva from Denmark. Are they allied with them? No, they aren't. Secure Western Siberia. Yeah, they got fatter fish to fry, I guess. But yeah, for now, thanks for watching. Hope you join me next time. Bye-bye.